This tutorial demonstrates how to use timelines. We have already prepared some images for this tutorial. Press the import button on the library title, and add images for a butterfly's body and wings. You'll also need to add a new timeline to the library. This automatically opens the timeline editor. Timelines allow you to create animations that play independently from the movie. Arrange the different parts of the butterfly in the editor. Add new frames for both wings at time 5 and 10. We are going to animate the butterfly so it looks like its wings are flapping. Select frame 5 for each wing and resize them so it looks like the butterfly has closed its wings. Press play to test the timeline. To be neat and tidy, resize the timeline to about the size of the butterfly. When you are happy with the animation, close the timeline editor and return to the main movie. In the properties for the timeline, turn on loop. Drag the butterfly timeline to the editor. In this example, the butterfly starts small on the left, comes in close in the center, and then flies away to the right. We added some rotation and curve transitions to make it more like the flight of a butterfly. Here are the three butterfly frames at 0, 40, and 80. Press play to test the final animation. The butterfly follows the path you have created, and also flaps its wings.